Hallelujah, hallelujah, all praises to our Heavenly Father. I just want to remind you about the upcoming Sabbath day. Next Monday, November the 4th, the 4th of November, next Monday, this coming Monday, November 4th, 2019, will be the next Sabbath, the first Sabbath of the 8th biblical month. The first Sabbath of the 8th month, right now in the biblical calendar. Right now in the calendar of our Heavenly Father, in the lunar calendar, we are on the 8th month right now, while the world is in, I think the world is in the 11th month. In the biblical calendar, in the calendar that the Most High created when He created this world, we are currently right now on the 8th month. So next Monday, the 4th of November 2019 will be the next Sabbath. That's when the Sabbath will be. So I just wanted to remind you so that you can get ready, prepare yourself, get your food, get the things that you need. Remember, we are not supposed to cook on the Sabbath. We're not supposed to cook on the Sabbath or buy on the Sabbath or sell on the Sabbath or travel on the Sabbath or sex on the Sabbath. We're not supposed to do all of that. We're supposed to rest on a Sabbath day and worship on a Sabbath day. That's what I wanted to remind you. And also, Jubilees chapter 50. If you want to learn more on how to keep the Sabbath, if you want to learn more, go to Google. Google Jubilees chapter 50. Jubilees chapter 50 and read the whole chapter. You will be able to learn how to observe the Sabbath. So that the next Sabbath will be on Monday, November 4th, 2019. That will be the next Sabbath. And of course, I'm talking about the biblical Sabbath here. I'm not talking about Saturday, because Saturday is not the Sabbath. Sunday is not the Sabbath. So if you're watching this for the first time, you might be wondering, wow, what does he mean that Monday is the Sabbath? Yes, next Monday will be the Sabbath, because the man-made calendar is changing. This calendar is a man-made calendar. This calendar is a pagan calendar, a Gregorian calendar. I'm not talking about this calendar. We are not supposed to keep the Sabbath using this calendar. This is a man-made calendar. This is not the calendar that the Most High created. When our Heavenly Father created this world, He made the moon to be the calendar. God's calendar is different from man-made calendar. You know what? Check this out. Watch this. This is for those who are watching this video for the first time. If you're watching this for the first time and you have no idea what I'm talking about, watch this and then we'll come back and continue.
We began this sermon by quoting Genesis 1:14, and God said, "Let there be lights in the heaven to divide the day and the night, and let them be for signs or signals." When I was in Washington talking to Pastor Mark Blitz, he asked me if I'd ever considered the study of the lunar eclipse with regard to a prophetic signal. I said, "No." He said, "You should." So I came home, and thinking about what the pastor had said, I sat down at my computer and began to work. I knew that our Bible, this one, was written on the lunar calendar. Our calendar, the Western civilization calendar, is the Gregorian calendar from Pope Gregory of Rome. That means it's pagan in origin. It's not God's calendar. Our calendar and the calendar of this book do not match. Sun God is for Sunday. Moon God is for Monday. That's a sermon for another time. Believe me, much of what Christianity salutes is pagan to its roots. The thought registered in my brain that maybe the heavens are God's billboard and He's sending us a signal, but we're not getting it. So I began to look up.
So as you can see, that was a Christian pastor admitting to you, okay? A Christian pastor is admitting, telling you the truth. And that truth is a truth that they don't normally tell. Christian pastors don't normally admit this. But here you have a Christian pastor admitting to you that God's calendar is the moon. That's why the phases of the moon changes every night. The Most High created the sun and the moon to be our calendar. He created the sun and the moon to be our calendar. That's why the phases of the moon changes every night. That's why the word month, that word month comes from the moon. The word month comes from the moon. So last Monday was a new moon day. because New Moon Day begins the month. New Moon Day begins the biblical month. And according to Ezekiel chapter 46, Ezekiel chapter 46, verse 1 to 3, we are supposed to worship on a new moon day. We are supposed to worship on a new moon day according to Ezekiel chapter 46, verse 1 to 3. If you look at Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 1 to 12, Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 1 to 12, you see how our ancestors worshiped on a new moon day. If you go to Colossians chapter 2, Colossians chapter 2, verse 1 to 16, Colossians chapter 2, verse 1 to 16, pay attention in verse 8. If you read that place, you see how Paul was telling the early followers of Christ not to let anybody condemn them or judge them for worshiping on the Sabbath day, on the new moon day, and on the feast days. So new moon day is a worship day. And then after you worship on the new moon day, because new moon day begins the month, new moon day begins the biblical month. And on the evening of that new moon day, on the evening of the new moon day, the first crescent of the moon will come out. The first tiny crescent of the moon will come out on the evening of the new moon day. So on the new moon day, you worship. You go to worship and you worship in the morning. You can cook on the new moon day. You can cook on the new moon day. But new moon day is a worship day according to Ezekiel 46. So we worship on the new moon day. That evening, the first crescent of the moon will come out. The next day after the new moon day, you go to work. You work for 6 days and then you rest on the seventh day. On that seventh day, the moon is going to look about 50% full. The moon will look about 50% full. So I guarantee you, I want you to test this. I want you to check this out. Tomorrow or Monday, November, the 4th of November, November 4, 2019. The 4th of November, 2019. Go out that evening and look outside. The moon will... I guarantee you this. I really want you to try it. Try it, and if you don't see that the moon is 50% full, come and comment up below this video. Then that means I'm a liar. I guarantee you the moon is going to be half on Monday, November 4, 2019. So the Most High did this intentionally. So it doesn't matter where you are in the world. From the new moon day, it takes 7 days for the moon to become half. So you worship on the new moon day. The next day you go to work. You work for 6 days and then you rest on the seventh day. On that seventh day, the moon will be 50% full. Half moon. The moon will look about 50% full. You worship, you rest. Then you next day you go to work. You work for 6 days and then you rest on the seventh day. On these 7 days, the moon will be 100% full. The moon will look around 100% full. You worship, you rest. The next day you go to work. You work for 6 days, you rest on the Sabbath. This is so simple, very basic and very simple. So the reason why the Sabbath is on the 4th of November 2019 is because last Monday, the 28th of October, last Monday, look in the man-made calendar and you see for yourself. Count from 28th of October 2019. Count 7 days. That will put you on Monday, November 4th, 2019. From October 28, 2019, which was a Monday, to if you count 7 days, that will put you on Monday, November 4th, 2019. It's so simple because New Moon Day was on October 28, 2019. 28th of October 2019 was the New Moon Day. We worshipped on the New Moon Day. The next day, we go to work. You work for 6 days, you rest on the seventh day. So that's when the next Sabbath day is going to be. I just wanted to give you like a brief information. This is not a full presentation. If you want to learn more, look under this video right now. Look under this video or go inside the Coming Kingdom app and tap on Learn Sabbath. That app is free. Go into the download Coming Kingdom app, tap on Learn Sabbath, or look under the YouTube channel, Coming Kingdom YouTube channel. Look under this video and tap on Coming Kingdom Broadcast. Go inside the main channel. Go inside my main YouTube channel and you'll be able to watch a longer video that will give you more information about this. This is just a reminder and to get your attention because Saturday is not the Sabbath, Sunday is not the Sabbath. And also the day begins from dawn to dawn. The day does not begin from evening to evening. The day begins from dawn to dawn, from morning to the next morning. So the next Sabbath will be from morning of Monday, November 4th, 2019 to Tuesday, November 5th, 2019. So Sabbath will begin from morning at dawn, you know, like very early in the morning, when this before the sun comes up. That time that the daylight begins to appear, dawn, that's when the day begins. The day does not begin from evening to evening. The day does not begin from 12 midnight to 12 midnight. No, the day begins from dawn to dawn. Look at Matthew 28 verse 1. Matthew 28 verse 1. If you read it and you see for yourself, there are other scriptures like Exodus chapter 19. Exodus chapter 19 from verse 10. If you read that, you will see. Joshua chapter 6. So it's very clear the day begins from dawn to dawn. So the Sabbath will be from Monday, Monday morning at dawn. November 4th at dawn in the morning. Sabbath will end the next morning. The next morning at dawn on Tuesday morning, November the 5th, 2019. So Sabbath will be from Monday morning to Tuesday morning at dawn before the sun comes up. So you have to prepare everything you need to prepare the night before. The night before, you cook your food, you prepare everything and make sure everything is ready. No buying on the Sabbath, no selling on the Sabbath, none of that. And you're supposed to rest on the Sabbath and worship on the Sabbath. If you don't have anybody to worship with, we do meet online. We meet online. All you need is just your internet access. Just have your phone. If you have a phone and you can go, you know, of course you can. That's why you're watching this video right now. So all you need is just a phone. So you can contact me if you need people to worship with. It doesn't matter where you are because we meet online. You can use your phone to join us for worship. You can contact me if you're interested in joining us. If you don't join us, that's fine. Just stay home. The most important thing is that you don't go to work on the Sabbath. You don't cook on the Sabbath. You rest on the Sabbath and you worship on the Sabbath. So if you have nobody to worship with, you can worship by yourself. Pray by yourself, worship yourself, and stay home yourself. If you would like to join us for worship, contact me. Send me a message and contact me. Let's see what we can do about that. I might be able to add you in to join us. I don't know. I might be able, but you can contact me first. And if you would like to join other brothers and sisters, we have people around the world, in different parts of the world, and we meet together on the Sabbath and we worship. You don't have to do that. You can worship by yourself, as you can see in Exodus chapter 16 from verse 16 to 30. Exodus chapter 16 from verse 16 to 30, you see that our Heavenly Father told our ancestors to stay home and rest, stay in their tent. So you don't have to join us, but if you would like to join us, it's up to you. You can contact me. Most important thing is that you remember that Monday, November 4th, 2019 is the Sabbath day. You're supposed to rest on that day. No buying, no cooking, no selling, no sex. That day is a rest day. You read Jubilees chapter 50 to learn more on how to keep the Sabbath. And look under this video, learn about the lunar calendar. Saturday is not the Sabbath. Saturday is not the Sabbath. Sunday is not the Sabbath. You have to go back and use the biblical calendar. You have to use the calendar of our Heavenly Father to keep the Sabbath. Use the lunar calendar. It's very simple. New Moon Day begins the month. You worship on the New Moon Day according to Ezekiel chapter 46 verse 1 to 3. You worship on the New Moon Day. The next day, you go to work. You work for 6 days. You rest on the seventh day. The moon will look about 150% full. About half moon. You worship on that day. The next day, you go to work. You work for 6 days. You rest on the seventh day. The moon will look about 100% full. You worship on that day. You rest on that day. You praise on that day. The next day you go. This is so simple. It's very basic, very simple. I thank our Heavenly Father for everything. If you have any question, feel free to contact me. My contact information is going to be at the end of this video. Feel free to call me or contact me or text me or email me or Skype me or WhatsApp me if you have any question relating to this. I give our Heavenly Father all the glory and all the honor. And thank you for everything. I hope you have a peaceful Sabbath. All praises to our Heavenly Father.